this Pandavas. Vyudham Drupada Putrena Tava Shishena Dhimata is wantonly pricking Dronacharya now. He says, it's your disciple who has come and collected his army against us. It's so unfortunate that I am having you in my army. Vyudham Drupada Putrena Tava Shishena Dhimata. This Drupada Putra is your disciple. Is your Shishya, whereas you are with me and he is just against me. Vasheka Panduputrana Acharya Padim Chamum. The Sanskrit is a great language. I will explain to you two meanings here. Vasheka Yeta, this Panduputrana Mahadim Chamum, the army belonging to Panduputra, Yeta, He Pasha, Acharya Pasha. Oh Acharya, please have a look at it. This is one way to interpret. I read the sloka. Pashetam Panduputrana Acharya Mahadim Chamum. Panduputrana Mahadim Chamum. This big army belonging to Panduputra. Hey Acharya. Who Acharya? Pascha. Can we look at it? This is what the right meaning is. Whereas the thought what Duryodhana was thinking in is Panduputrana Acharya Yetam Mahadim Chamum Pascha. Let's interpret it like that. It means, you are not an Acharya to me, oh Panduputranam Acharya. You are always biased to Panduputras only. When are you going to make me victorious? So Panduputranam Acharya Pasya. If you just join these two words, it becomes that Duryodhanacharya's bias. If you separate these two words, it's okay, he's unbiased. Pashyetam Panduputranam Acharya Mahatim Chamum. Vyudham Drupadaputrena Tapashishena Dhimata. And what does Duryodhana talk to Dronacharya? He says, Aparyaptam Tadasmakam Balam Bhishma Virakshitam. Paryaptam Tidamedesham Balam Bhima Virakshitam. Aparyaptam, Paryaptam. Aparyaptam is unlimited. Paryaptam is limited. Aparyaptam Tadasmakam. Our army is unlimited. It's too big because it's 11 Akshobhini number. Whereas Pandava Sainyam is 7 Akshobhini number. Akshobhini comprises of so number of chariots, so many number of horses, so many number of army people, and that's an Akshobhini. It's made, it comprises of many different, it constitutes that. So it's an Akshobhini. Pashyetam Panduputranam Acharya, we are big, we are unlimited. Aparyaptam Tadasmakam Balam Bhishma Virakshitam. We are being led by Bhishma. We are being protected by Bhishma. Bhishma was the first Senapati. After his death, it was Dronacharya. Then on, it started changing. So the first chieftain, the Senapati was Bhishmacharya. Aparyaptam Tadasmakam. Our army is unlimited. Balam Bhishma Virakshitam. We are being led. We are being protected by Bhishma. You see, there are me. Paryaptam. It's limited. It's not that big. Paryaptam tida vayatesha. Balam bhima virakshitam. Protected by bhima. Here, the Gita Bhashya was made by Adi Shankara Bhagavatpada, by Ramanujacharya, by Madhvacharya. Now, Ramanujacharya Gita Bhashyam is as per Vishishta Advaita philosophy. Shankara Bhashyam is as per Advaita philosophy. Madhva Bhashyam is as per Dvaita philosophy. There have been very many great noble souls who have kept on even today. They are writing commentaries on Gita because to take a gem, the way you look at it, the precious gem, it gets value added. The more you look at it, the more you rub it, it gets more shine. So Gita, as much as you dwell, as much as you inquire into it, you get more meanings from the Gita. So Ramanujacharya, his Bhashyam is known as Gita Bhashyam. And there is a further commentary to Ramanuja Bhashyam known as Tatparya Chandrika by Vedanta Deshika. That's a very, very detailed study on Gita Bhashyam. There, Tatparya Chandrika, Vedanta Deshika, he interprets this sloka. Is Duryodhana feeling happy when he is talking this? Or he is quite sad when he is talking this? He must be happy because he says, Aparyaptam Tadasmakam Bhishma Virakshitam. Our army is so big, unlimited, and protected by Bhishma. Who is Bhima there? Whereas Bhishmacharya is a well-renowned archer and who can stand against him? So Duryodhana must be happy. Whereas Deshikan said, no, he is so sad when making this statement. Why is it so? Because you have to look at the next verse. Any time when you write a commentary, you must have an eye on all the verses later and before. nothing can be commented upon in an absolute sense. Already I told you things are relevant. So if you want to explain this verse, it should have relevance to the next verse. If not, there is no point in commenting it absolutely. The next verse says like this, Tasya Sanjayan Harisham Kuruvurtha Pitamaha Pitamaha Bhishma. He took his conch and blew his conch so that he brings happiness to Duryodhana. This is the next verse. If someone says that I have to bring happiness to me, that would mean I am not happy earlier. Should I assume that or not? I am not happy. I am sad. Why is he sad? Aparyaptam tadasmatam balam bhishma virakshitam. We are protected by Bhishma. They are protected by Bhima. This is again a wrong usage of word. He should not have uttered the word Bhima there. The reason is, if Bhishma is the Senapati here, who is the Senapati there? Drishtadyumna. So Duryodhana should have said, Balam Bhishma Virakshitam, Balam Drishtadyumna Avirakshitam. He did not say so. He said Bhima Virakshitam. Bhima is not the Senapati there. Forget Senapati. If you say that Bhishmacharya is the oldest person here, you have got very many older people than Bhima. You should not have mentioned the name. If you assume that Bhishmacharya was the greatest archer here, you must have put Arjuna against Bhishmacharya, because Bhima knows the war of Gada, not with this bow and arrow. So in every sense, Duryodhana has put the wrong person on the other side. He was not the Senapati, he was not a great archer, he was not the oldest, he was no way great when compared to Bhishmacharya. Whereas voluntarily Duryodhana is using Balam Bhishma Virakshitam, Balam Bhima Virakshitam. What does he have in his mind now? The reason is, I have one Bhishmacharya who has taken a vow. I have got there one Bhima who has resolved himself. He too has taken a vow. And you know that these two vows of Dronacharya, here is one person who has said, I might kill everyone except five. Whereas that Bhishma has said, that Bhima has taken a vow, I might leave anyone, not the 100. These are the two vows. Now Bhishmacharya has resolved, I would kill anyone, but not the five Pandavas. This is the resolution passed by Bhishmacharya. Whereas Bhima has also taken a vow, I might kill anyone, but not this 100 Kauravas. Now I have a person here, my army is protected by a person who has taken a vow not to kill the enemies. And there you find a person there who has vowed to kill all of us. So aparyaptam tadasmatam balam bhishma virakshitam, paryaptam to the vedesham balam bhima virakshitam. But still, we have not answered the usage of aparyaptam and paryaptam. Aparyaptam is unlimited. When I say it's unlimited, I should feel happy when I mention it there. When I say that is limited, I am degrading him. But still he is sad. The meaning of these two words should be changed now. Aparyaptam is not unlimited. It means it is not enough. Paryaptam, it is enough. Aparyaptam tadasmatam. Our army is not enough to finish the Pandavas army. Their army is enough to finish our army. So aparyaptam and paryaptam are not unlimited and limited. They mean it's enough. Our army is not enough because army is quite big in number. Unfortunately, I have got a Senapati who has taken this vow. So it's not enough. Their army is smaller, but they have got a Senapati. They have got this Bhima who has taken a vow to kill all of us. Aparyaptam tadasmatam balam bhishma virakshitam. Paryaptam vidameshetam balam bhima virakshitam. Tasya sanjayan harsham kuruvritta pitamaha. And then the next word gains importance now. Tasya sanjayan harsham. So he brought happiness. Pitamaha. Bhishmacharya overheard the conversation between Drona and Duryodhana. He immediately understood that my son, my grandson is feeling very sad. So he wanted to make him happy. Tasya Sanjayan Harsham. He blew his conch and thus Duryodhana became happy. He was sad earlier. Now he was made happy. Kuruvritta Pitamaha. So these were the arguments and the actions in one side. Now let's go to the other side. This is just a drama being narrated by Sanjaya to Dhritarashtra. On the other side, it's a practice. Before the army started to fight, all will blow their conches, their shankha. So one side now, Bhishmacharya has already given notice that I am going to start this war. On the other side, Panchajanyam Rishikeshaha, ದೇವದತ್ತನ್ ಧನಂಜಯ ಋಷಿಕೇಶ ಋಷಿಕೇಶ ಇಸ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹೆಸರ್ ಋಷಿಕೇಶ ಋಷಿಕ ಇಂದ್ರಿಯ ಅವರ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಋಷಿಕೇಶ ಒನ್ ಹೂ ಹಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಇಂದ್ರಿಯಾಸ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ ಋಷಿಕೇಶ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕೀಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕಿಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ಸನ್ ಋಷಿಕೇಶ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ನೇಮ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಋಷಿಕ ಇಂದ್ರಿಯ ಋಷಿಕೇಶ ಒನ್ ಯು ಹಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಯು ಹಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಮ್ಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಇಂದ್ರಿಯಾಸ್ ಪಾಂಚಜನ್ಯಂ ಋಷಿಕೇಶ ಋಷಿಕೇಶ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹಿ ಬ್ಲೂ ಹಿಸ್ ಪಾಂಚಜನ್ಯಂ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಂಚಜನ್ಯಂ ಇಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಕಾಂಚ್ which finds a place on his divine left hand. You find Sudarshana on his right hand of Shivan Narayana. You find Shankha on his left hand. Right and left, Valakkai Aadi, Idakkai Changam. Alvar always says this, Valakkai Aadi, the right hand he holds the Sudarshanara Chakra, Idakkai Changam. On his left hand, he holds the divine conch. Krishna lifted that Panchajanya Rishikesha, Rishikesha, one who has controlled his senses, one who has controlled his indriya, he started blowing. Now, Vedavyasa, or for that matter Sanjaya, could have told Panchajanyam Krishna, Panchajanyam Vasudeva, Panchajanyam Govinda. They would have mentioned any name of Krishna. Why Rishikesha? Every name when it is applied in Gita, it gains importance. Why he says here Indriya Jaya, one who has controlled his senses, that means Krishna is unbiased when he blew his conch. His job was not to make Pandavas victorious, was not to win a battle for them, but to establish Dharma. So one who is unbiased, his wish is to only establish Dharma, and who can be unbiased? One who has controlled his senses. Unless I control my Indriya, I will be biased. When I control my indriyam, then everything looks the same for me. Then only I become an unbiased person. So the samatvam is very, very important. If I should look at everyone in equanimity, then I must be able to control my senses to some extent. Since Rishikesha is a person who has controlled his senses, this word goes to prove, never think that Krishna was biased towards Pandavas, he was unbiased. Don't think that he has taken sides with Pandavas. His only aim is to establish Dharma. So he takes sides with Dharma, not Adharma. So let's not think that Krishna was biased. He has taken sides with Pandava. It's not so. His only aim is to establish Dharma. That is why here Vedavyasa uses the word Rishikesha. One who has controlled his senses will only worry about Dharma, not whether it is Pandavas or Kauravas. Panchajanyam Rishikesha. He blew his conch. ದೇವದತ್ತನ್ ಧನಂಜಯ ಧನಂಜಯ ಧನ ಜಯ ವಾಸ್ ಅರ್ಜುನ ದೇವದತ್ತ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಪಾಂಚ್ ಶಂಕ ಆಫ್ ಅರ್ಜುನ ಪೌಂಡ್ರಂ ದದ್ಮುಹು ಪೌಂಡ್ರಂ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ನಕುಲ ಸಹದೇವ ಧರ್ಮಪುತ್ರ ಆಲ್ ಡೂ ದೇರ್ ಪಾಂಚಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ರೆಡಿ ಎರಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫೈಟ್ ಎರಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಅಹೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಟಲ್ ಪಾಂಚಜನ್ಯ ಋಷಿಕೇಶ ಆನ್ ಹಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಲಿಸನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನಾಯ್ಸ್ On hearing the blow of the conch of Krishna, immediately Vedavyasa explains here the plight of Duryodhana and his brothers. Sagosho Dhartharatrana Hridayani Vyadarayat. Sagosha, that noise of Shankha, Hridayani Vyadarayat, they were just shattered. They couldn't stand anymore. Hridayani Vyadarayat. All the Kauravas are shattered. Now, after chanting this sloka, Sanjaya paused for a moment. He just looked at Dhritarashtra. Has he got my first indirect reply? What was the question? The question where he started was, Mamaka Pandava Seva, Kim Abhurvata Sanjaya, what do my sons and the sons of Pandava, what are they doing there? And the reply is, here is your son who on hearing the noise of Panchajanya has got shattered. Where is the question of asking whether he is going to win or lose now? The battle is already lost. So the first indirect reply by Sanjaya was this statement. Sagosho Dhartharatrana Hridayani Vyadarayat. They were all shattered. Now, the same Panchajanya brought happiness to Rukmini Pirati. I will have to mention that also. Rukmini Sandesham is very, very important in Srimad Bhagavatam. Rukmini fell in love with Krishna. She wanted to marry her. If at all there would be some other, she would die. But for Krishna, she would not marry anyone. But Krishna, she did not note her. he should have also fallen out with her. But unfortunately it was, he is saying Tamil, as Gurudarai Kaadal, it's a one-way love, which Rukmini had. It was a two-way love, but Krishna could not come and convey his love. You will find some lovers who will keep on loving, who can't talk, who can't open their mouth. Our Krishna is like that. He could not talk, but she just collected courage. Rukmini had the courage to write a letter. She wrote the 7 slokas, gave it to a Brahmin and sent it through him and sent him as an messenger. This Brahmin came to Dwaraka, he handed over the letter to Krishna. Krishna started reading and gave it back to the Brahmin. I am not used to getting such letters. Oh Brahmin, you please go through that. And there Rukmini says that Shukma Gunan Bhuvana Sundar Shismatante Nirvishya Karna Vivareti Haratonga Tapam. I have heard about your divine attributes, Krishna. I have lost myself. I have surrendered myself to you. It is whom I should marry. And there Rukmini says, you might now be wondering how to get me married, how to get me. And she gives the place where to come, how to come, where to take away me. Everything is mentioned in those 7 slokas. She says there, Purve Durasti Mahadeepana Deva Yatra, on the eve of my marriage day, I have to go and perform puja to my Kula Devi. I'll go there. You come with your chariot to that place with Daruga, your charioteer. I will just keep waiting for you. You blow your conch, I will understand that you have come there. I will come running, you elope with me. And this is what Rukmini said in Rukmini Sandesha. There Krishna came and started blowing his conch. Andal says, Pungal Tirumuhattu Maluttudiya Shankoli. Shankoli, Pungal Tirumukam. The lotus mouth of Krishna, we know that it will pour nectar as Venugana, but it has started pouring nectar Amrita through his conch. Pungal Tirumuhattu Maluttudiya Shankoli. Now you take these 2 instances. This is one place where when Krishna blew his conch, people were shattered. This is another place when Krishna blew his Panchajanya, Rukmini felt so happy. Does this Panchajanya change color? One way it is making people happy. The other place it's making people shattered. That never changes. Conch remains the same. Panchajanya remains the same. Krishna is the same. But it is the thought which we have in our mind. When we go to him with an anupula sankalpa, it gives pleasure to us. When we go to him with the pratipula sankalpa, it shatters us. So, Duryodhana thought they were the enemies of Krishna, it shattered them. Rukmini thought that she belongs to Krishna, it brought happiness to them. So, Lord is always the same. It is how you look at him. If you go to him so that you want to have him, if you think you are his enemy, then of course he never comes near you. Now, we think, Bhagavan thought that he is a mother cat and we are his kitten. We assumed Bhagavan as mother cat. Unfortunately, we thought we were rats. That's the problem. We thought you would be mother and you are a kitten. So that he protects of the kitten. Whereas I thought, I rightly assumed Bhagavan, he is a cat. But unfortunately, I am a rat. So whenever he came to rescue me, I thought he is going to catch me and I started running. So it's we who have to go near him in the right sense. If you go to him with an anupula sankalpa, his panchajanyam brings you pleasure. If you go to him with a wrong sense, the same panchajanyam never helps you, it shatters you. I'll give you another example. Lakshmana was hit by Shakti Ayuta of Ravana. Lakshmana felt unconscious. Ravana wanted to take away Lakshmana. He knew the secret. If Rama is separated from Lakshmana, Rama is no more. Ravana knew about this. But for Lakshmana, Rama would not live. You could have heard story of Srimad Ramayana where Sita was separated from Rama. This 10 months she was separated in Ashokavana. And before marriage they were separated. Before marriage, 6 years Sita had to wait before getting married to Rama. Then too she was separated. And when she was pregnant, she was left in Valmiki Ashrama. She got separated. But can anyone cite one moment when Lakshmana was separated from Rama? You can find many places where Sita was separated, not Lakshmana. Without Lakshmana, Rama cannot live. That much was the love which Lakshmana and Rama did enjoy between themselves. So Lakshmana is unconscious. Ravana thought, if I take him away to my place, I can finish Rama without this battle. He came to the battlefield. He thought Lakshmana is a human. He is just a Manushya. I can lift him. He just tried with his left arm. He could not. He He used all his 10 left hands, he could not. He used his 20 hands, he could not. And Ravana made this statement, Sakyam Bhujabhyam Uddhartam Nasakye Bharatanuja. I have lifted Melpavata with my left hand, I have lifted Himalayas with my left right hand. How is that I am not able to lift this Lakshmana? Nasakye Bharatanuja. So he lamented and left the battlefield. Next, Hanuman gave Lagutta Bhagavad Kapege. With ease, Hanuman took away Lakshmana to their side. Now Valmiki, he is also quite tricky. Whenever he uses words, he knows how to hit people. What he did here? He said that Ravana tried with 20 arms. Ravaneshwara, Lankeshwara, the Almighty almost. He tried with 20 hands, could not. Whereas Hanuman came. Now here Valmiki should have qualified Hanuman somewhat equal to Ravana, so that he lifted Lakshmana. You know the word which he is using? Lagutta Madhavadil Kapehe. A simple monkey lifted Lakshmana. If a monkey lifts Lakshmana, what does it mean? Did Lakshmana become heavy when Ravana came? Did Lakshmana become so light when Hanuman came? Lakshmana was unconscious. He was not heavy or he was not light. But how you came towards him, how you approached Lakshmana is important. Ravana did not approach rightly, Hanuman approached him rightly. So it is our sense, our thinking process which is important, not the God. God remains the same, Samoham, whereas we should approach him in the right sense. Ravana did not do it properly, he could not, whereas he is a monkey. So it goes to prove, even if you are a monkey, you have the right thinking about your Lord, you can have it. Even if you are Lankeshwara, you think anything against him, you cannot know about him. So that is now here displayed. It said there that Panchajanyam Rishikesha Devadatta Bharajaya Savoshota Aktaratrana Hridayani Vedarayat. Thus all the Hridaya, the hearts of these Kauravas were shattered. Anantavijayam Raja Kunti Putro Yudhishthira Nakula Sahadevascha Subhosha Manipushpakav Savoshota Aktaratrana Hridayani Vedarayat. Then the next happening was very important. Arjuna said, let me first take a look at both the armies. Before you start fighting, you must know the bala bala, the strength and the weaknesses. We say SWOT analysis today. Whereas they used to do SWOT analysis, the strength, weakness, opportunities and threats. First we must know that. So Arjuna wanted to conduct, to know what was the threat available to him and what was the strength and weaknesses, strength of his army, weakness. Strength and weakness are there. He said, Senayor Ubhayor Madhye Ratham Sthavayam Echyuta Ko Achyuta Senayor Ubhayor Madhye. Between the two armies, place my chariot. Just drive my chariot between the two armies. Krishna immediately Yavadedan Nirikshayam Yodhutaman Avasthitan. Let me have a look at the people who have collected, gathered here to fight. So immediately Krishna responded, Yeva Muktaha Rishikesha Gudakeshena Bharata Senayor Ubhayor Madhye Sthapayitva Rathottamam. Immediately Krishna obeyed to the words of Arjuna and he drove the chariot and placed them before the, between the two armies. Senayor Ubhayor Madhye Sthapayitva. Now there is no question being asked by Krishna, O Arjuna, you are a Nitya Samsari. I am Lord incarnated here and you are ordering me to do a job. Krishna had a question. He immediately obeyed. So here is the Samsari who is ordering. Here is the Maheshwara who is obeying to the order. Now Sanjaya looks at Dhritarashtra and says that, have you got my second indirect reply? The reason is, a Samsari is ordering and Sarvaloka Maheshwara is obeying to your order, you keep on telling Mahabhata Pandava Krishna himself is obeying to the order of Arjuna. The battle is already won. There is no point in talking whether it's going to be Pandavas or the Kauravas. Whenever when Krishna sat there as a charioteer, the battle was over. The battle was over at that moment. Now Krishna says later, during Vishwarupa Darshana, Arjuna questions Krishna, Ko Bhavan Ugra Rupa. Later on in the 10th and 11th chapter, Vishwarupa Darshana and Vibhuti Yoga. At that instance, Arjuna questions Krishna, Ko Bhavan Ugra Rupa. Who are you? You are looking like Kala. Who are you? I am just frightened at your sight. Krishna said, yes, Aham Kalo Smi, Aham Kala. You know who you are? Nimitta Matram Bhava Sabhyasachinda Tato Yudhyayi Yudhyasva Yashola Bhaswa. You are not the one who is going to fight this battle. Nimitta Matram Bhava. You be the instrument. I have concluded this battle long back, Arjuna. Arjuna thought, now only we are in the 10th chapter, we are yet to go another 8 chapters, then the war should start, then it's 18 days. How is that Krishna is commenting? He has already concluded the war. Krishna said, I concluded the moment I blew my conch. Not now. When I blew my panchajanya, I have shattered them. When I proved to this world that I am a charioteer to you, and that is when I decided the result of this war. Serai Uru Bayodmati, Ratham Stavaya Vechuta. So this, you have to know a prior story to this. Both Duryodhana and Arjuna wanted to seek the help of Krishna. Both of them wanted his help. So Krishna was reclining, he was sleeping. Both Arjuna and Duryodhana came. Arjuna took his place near the lotus feet of Krishna. Duryodhana, as usual, he was Ahankara Grastha. He took his place near the head of Krishna. Whenever we go to Bhagavan, it's his feet which is more important to us. Not his shoulders, not his hands, not his head. It is the lotus feet as the child is fond of the mother, the whole body of the mother. But still, an infant would love wherever milk flows to it. So that part is more important to a child. For us too, the whole body of Bhagavan is very important. But more important is where we can perform Sharanagati. To his lotus feet only we can surrender. So its feet is the most important part. As far as Sansaris are concerned, unfortunately Duryodhana took the head side, Arjuna took the feet side, and slowly Krishna awoke. He woke up. He sighted only Arjuna first. Because it's a practice. Whenever we wake up, we will look at the feet side only. No one will turn back and look who is sitting on my headboard. I won't look at it. So Arjuna, Krishna sighted Arjuna. Both of them came to him. And Duryodhana said that we have come to seek help from you. Krishna said, okay, that's no problem. Now you can, Arjuna, you can ask first. Duryodhana immediately, he objected and said, I came here first. Arjuna came next to me. I have the right to ask you first. You must give me first. But as Krishna said, there are two reasons, Duryodhana. I saw only Arjuna first. I saw you later, so you must ask later. And the second, Dharma Shastra says that the younger one takes precedence over the elder. The younger has got the first right to ask. Then only the elder can ask. Maybe that's true with many families. The elder one is normally with sattvic qualities. It's the younger one which will create all the problems. So here too, now Krishna said, the younger one is Arjuna. You are the elder. Let Arjuna first ask. Immediately Arjuna started asking, which are the options available to us? One side is Vaishnava Sainya, my Sena, my army, which has got 1 crore, 10 million. 10 million people in that. But at the other side, I am alone. I have no army. I have got no helpers with me. None with me. I am alone. Now choose between these two. And that time Arjuna was to ask. Duryodhana was just praying, God, this stupid must not ask for the sainya. Then I am lost. Because he was wanting to have the Vaishnava sainya. Fortunately, Arjuna asked, oh Krishna, Krishna Shayava, Krishna Varava, Krishna Natascha Pandava, I only know you. I don't know anyone else. Oh Krishna, I am too happy if you come and join me. And there, Duryodhana thanked all the gods possible on earth. And fortunately, Arjuna has asked for Krishna. He is stupid. He doesn't know even to think. He has taken this Krishna, this cowherd boy. What can he do? So all these things have earlier happened. Arjuna wanted Krishna to be in his side. So the moral of the story is, forget anything else other than Bhagavan. If you get him as your wealth, everything will follow suit. You get anything else other than him, whatever you possess is worthless. It's of no worth. If you don't have Bhagavan by the side of you, you have crores and crores and billions with you, it means nothing. Because you will find them today, next day you won't find them. And it's true. And I need not explain to this country about that. Whatever you found, there are just two buildings. These two buildings, the havoc which they have caused in this country, stands as a testimony now. They are all made of brick and mortar. What more is those two buildings now? They are just built by us. It's not built by God. It is mankind, it is human beings who built that. It's a happening. Happening should be left as a happening. Never make them an event. Both are different now. Happening, just leave them as happenings. The value you attach, they become an event now. Suppose, no one had reported on September 11th, there was a power cut. No TV reported, no newspaper reported. What did you do? The stock market would not have crashed. The reason is, it is the value which we add to a happening that makes it an event. You don't add value to it. Just leave happenings as happenings. Let them happen. Why should you attach importance to them? My only happening which I am worried is, do I get to my Lord or not? Let that be an event. Unfortunately, no one takes notice of that event. Mm-hmm. You take notice of all other happenings. So Krishna says, Arjuna, ask for Krishna, who is the ultimate wealth. He is called Vaitamaniji in Tamil, in Trinalveli district, near Alvar Trinagari. You have a divination, Tirukkodur, and that divination Thirumal is known as Vaitamaniji. Vaitamaniji, one who is in a fixed deposit which will never fail. He is a deposit, he is a wealth. Nikshepa Raksha Apat Saka. Whenever you are in trouble, you can use the deposit. No one will say the interest is gone. No one will say the principal is gone. Both are intact forever and ever and ever. So Arjuna wanted Krishna's help. He sought for that. And Krishna went to Arjuna's help. The Duryodhana wanted other, and he went to all the Vaishnava Sainyam belonged to Duryodhana. Now that Sainyam was waiting along with Duryodhana, Sayayor Vayor Madhye, Stavayitvara Sottamam. And then Arjuna started looking both his armies, and he saw all his relatives and friends, his acharyas, his brothers, his pautras, putras, everyone on the other side. They say, Tatra Vashad, Siddhan Partha, Pitran, Atha, Pitamahan, Acharyana, Matulan, Dhradran, Putran, Pautran, all were found in the opposite camp. And that is when Arjuna got confused. Do I fight this battle or not? And he says, Kripaya Paraya Vitta, Vishidan Nidama Praveed. Kripaya Paraya Vitta. Arjuna almost became a coward by his mercy. Because he started showing mercy on the wrong hands, he became a coward. He could not decide. Kripaya Paraya Vitta. He was soaked in Kripa. He was full of sadness now. He was grief-stricken. Could not decide what to do. Vishidan Nidama Praveed. Started shivering. And slowly started blabbering something. If you shiver or you are full of sadness, you can't talk properly. You won't make sense. And he says, Drishvevam, Swajanam Krishna, Yuyutsam Samupasthitana. Hey Krishna, at the look of all these people, you know my plight. Sidanti mama gatrani, Mukhancha Parishushyati. Sidanti mama gatrani. I start shivering. Mukhancha Parishushyati. I become pale. Vepathuscha Sharireme, Romaharshasya Jayate. I am starting to sweat. Romaharshasya Jayate. I am not able to control my feelings. So at the look of all these people, and I look at all my, not my enemies on the opposite camp, my Acharya, my Mata, my Pita, my Pautra, my Matula, my Bratra, all my brothers are on the opposite camp. My Acharya, the font, the love, and the person who showered love and affection on me, Bhishmacharya, is on the other camp. My Acharya, the very Acharya himself, Dronacharya, is on the other camp. I find no one here, but everyone on the opposite camp. Sidanti mama gatrani, mukhaccha parishushyati, vevatuscha sharirene. So, I cannot do this battle. Nittani chan, vashyami, viparitani keshava. Gandivam sramsate hastad. Oh Krishna, my Gandivam bow is falling on its own from my arms. I am not able to hold it anymore. Nakamkshe vijayam Krishna, nacharajyam sukhanicha, kimno rajyam govinda, kim bhogehi jivitenava. I would not like to fight Krishna. The reason is, killing all my brothers, killing all my acharyas, on their funeral pyre, I would not like to build my kingdom. I only earn papa by this. If I kill all of them, then I will be bringing disgrace to my dynasty, to all my Kaurava dynasty. If I do that, I am ensured of a birth in Naraka. So I am not willing to go ahead with this battle. Thus, Arjuna lamented with Krishna, Acharyaha, Pitaraha, Putraha, Tateivaja Pitamaha, my grandfathers, my great-grandfathers, my father, fathers, everything is in plural. Fathers mean, it's not that we had many fathers. It's known as a father, father's brothers. Including the father's brothers, Ikaveriya Pajitapa, all together, Pitaraha, all the Pitas, the Pitamahas, my Dhrata, everyone is on, was found on the other side, Yeva Muktva, Arjunaha, ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ ರಥೋಪಸ್ಥ ಉಪಾವಿಶತ್ ದ ಬೌ ಫೆಲ್ ಡೌನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಹಿ ಕುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಟರ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ರಥ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನಿಂಗ್ ಅರ್ಜುನ ಓ ಅರ್ಜುನ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಯು ಆರ್ ಅ ಕಿಂಗ್ If you are a king, you must be a trendsetter. You must set an example to others. If you are behaving like a coward, if your bow well falls down from your arm, there's no point. I can go, I cannot advise others. So, the confused Arjuna is the instrument for the whole of Gita. Why is this confusion? Arthana Sneha, Arthana Karunya, Dharma Dharma Diyakulam. You should not have shown mercy towards the enemies. You should not have had kripa towards them. You should have decided which is right, which is wrong. So he made three mistakes. Asthana Sneha, Asthana Karunya, Dharma Dharma Diyakulam, Partham Prabhanna Uddishya. So a calf was Arjuna. The cow was the Upanishads. Cow bird was Krishna. And the milk, the divine nectar is Gita Murtam. So Gita was to clear the shoka of Arjuna. Where Krishna mentioned that 18th chapter 66th verse Maasuchaha. Don't worry. Ahamta Sarupavebhyo Mokshayishami Maasuchaha. Do not worry. He should have mentioned that in the first or second verse. If he had done that, we need not keep on going through all these 700 verses. But Krishna did do. He wanted to give us this great Gita Shastra. So, all through the first adhyaya, the essence is Atthana Sneha Kaunya Dharma Dharma Diyakulam Partham Prabhanna Buddhisya Shastravataranam Kritam. The first adhyaya is known as Arjuna Vishada Yoga. Arjuna Vishadam, the worry, the sadness, the grief of Arjuna revealed. Arjuna said, Arjuna revealed what his doubts were, what are the problems which he faced. Now in the second chapter, up to the 11th verse, must be added along with the first chapter only. Only from the 12th verse of second chapter actually begins. So the 11th verse till that belongs to the first chapter. All this is a preface to Gita. Gita Shastram starts only from the 12th verse of second chapter. So tomorrow evening we will go through the 11 shlokas, one or two. Now out of the 700, I might hardly be able to explain maximum about 70 shlokas in these 7 days. We can go through about 10, and this first adhyaya shlokas are all quite simple. You can easily understand the meaning. Come second adhyaya, if I have to explain, one shloka is going to take your day. So it will be difficult, but still, we will try to maintain pace, we will try to dwell on as much as shlokas as possible. So tomorrow evening at
5 o'clock.
So we have more time tomorrow, fortunately. So at 5 o'clock, we will assemble here for tomorrow evening. At least 2nd and 3rd, 4th chapter, we will try to complete. There are only 18. When I think about it, it's an uphill task now. We are left only with 6 days. So in those 6 days, we will try and cover 18 chapters. So the first excerpt is what we have started now. That talks about Karma Yoga and Jnana Yoga. That talks about Atma Sakshatkara. The second excerpt talks about Paramatma Sakshatkara and Bhakti Yoga. With that, almost the Gita is over. So the last 6 chapters, it's only reiteration, re-emphasizing what Krishna said earlier. So let us first concentrate on the first 12 chapters. Out of that, we have today dealt about the first chapter. Tomorrow, we will deal about second chapter, where the Nityatva of Atma, the eternal nature of the Jiva Atma, and the perishable nature of this body is well explained. Once you understand that, it's easy to lead our life. So the real beacon starts only tomorrow. Kindly assemble here tomorrow evening. Thank you for attending today. In case you have got any questions, you can go ahead.